Okay.
There, we're in. Yep.
Got it.
So Jerry, you must have logged in with a different account, not the Zoom.
I did the
Yeah, that
one
was
that you
three
sent in
IOTA
the recent
amateurs that saw
email.
those rings, actually.
Yes.
Yeah.
Jerry, it all depends, Jerry, which account you use last on Zoom, I think. And did
This.
you have a different account as well as the SBAU
No,
account?
I just used the account that you sent out in your email yesterday.
Well, okay. We're recording, I guess.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay, so going on with the meeting, for those that it didn't get recorded, the meeting was officially called to order at 5:02 p.m. It's 5:06 now. So we had a few minutes of panic discussion. So anyway, from Colin, we had a meeting on the budget and coordination between, not the budget, but coordination between the museum's accounting office and our accountant, Colin. And it looked like that meeting went okay, but I didn't hear at the meeting a statement from Colin that said that we had the right amount of money in there. Colin, have you looked at it and are we okay?
I haven't looked at the reconciliation yet, but we do have sufficient funds. She did acknowledge that she had the insurance payment, and I think we were waiting to investigate the money that Chuck said was wired directly.
And she had
Yes.
that too.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we're okay. I don't have a good figure yet. That's my next task is to try and figure out what that is and get up to date.
Okay. And
I
then if the museum starts hounding you for our donation, tell them it's on them. So we'll
Well, what did
do
Colin say
that.
about the insurance money?
She
We
did
have it. It's
acknowledge that
there.
she had that.
Yeah.
Okay.
So
So
that's
that.
15,000, and we have about 5,000 at least from wired money. And
Okay.
there was a little bit of more money. So we're good to cover the donation to the museum. So whenever, and I understand that from that meeting that we did not have a good, no one had a good understanding of how that donation would be made. By Venmo or PayPal
No,
or a
that
check.
Venmo and PayPal, we were talking about doing memberships and merchandise sales, and that is n a no-go because
No,
we
I understand that, but on the topic of how we make the donation to the
Oh,
museum,
why
that's
can't I
a
just cut
purchase
a
order.
purchase order?
Oh, that's right. That's right. Okay.
And
Yeah.
that I just will bring that up now. I don't know. I think I owe Tom one. And we're going to decide on the merchandise tonight. And we need the one for the museum. But is there any other outstanding purchase orders we need? Plus, do I need to pay somebody for the speaker?
No, the speaker declined.
Yeah, I know the one check I sent hasn't been cashed, so I never did do a purchase order for that one. But that
He
was
handed the check back.
okay.
So the Baron should have that.
So I don't owe anybody any money for speakers, and I just have the two purchase orders, one for Tom and one for the museum. And we'll see about merchandise tonight. Is that right?
Yeah.
Sounds good.
And you brought up the membership thing, and we did decide that Venmo and PayPal were no go.
Yeah.
So how do we tell people that membership payments, what's the right format?
Well, they
Credit
give the
card or
check or they
cash?
give cash.
Okay.
Or not credit card, check.
Check or cash. And Tom will have that shown there on our webpage.
Yeah, it's still got the old form on there.
Hi, Hank.
Hello,
Hello.
Hank.
Hi, Hank.
Hello.
So we got to get the new membership form up there. Otherwise,
Right.
we're confusing people. We have one thing in the newsletter and our handouts and something else on the webpage, but.
Okay, good. And oh yes, now to the merchandise.
I can share the screen in case people don't have that information, if that's okay with whoever's the host.
Of course.
Okay, all right, here we go. I've never done this before, so if it blows up,
You have to choose a window to share with us.
Okay. Yeah, open the document first and then choose share.
Oh.
And you got to pick the window the document's in. So it'll be Word or whatever you opened it in.
I see. It's a PDF. Yeah.
You should have opened it yesterday and then it'd be ready for today.
All right, let's see what happens. Okay. All right, they're open.
Now go down and do share screen. The big green thing in the middle at the bottom, or wherever you have your Zoom controls.
Okay, done.
Share screen, select the right one.
Hard to see some of the windows are so small you have to choose from.
All right, sometime tomorrow. All right, it wants me to go into preferences.
Oh, you probably don't have, you probably haven't given Zoom permission to share. And you'd have to restart Zoom to do it.
Yeah. All right, really? Never mind. Okay, we will just pretend.
No, the host usually can, it's a button down there to.
No, Jerry, no. It's permissions on security on the Apple that she's using.
Oh.
Huh. Well, Apple computers are really weird.
That happened to me. I had to go reset permissions and then re-enter Zoom before it came up with the permission to do that. So,
okay.
So you can read it, I guess.
All right. Okay, the two-tone mug. There's 72 that need to be ordered, and the net total is $742.92. And that's one. And then the tote bags, there's 24 that are quoted here for $696.87.
Well, that's about $1,500.
Yeah.
Anything else?
No.
Now the mugs, are these the bigger mugs or the small or the usual ones we sell?
These are the usual size.
Okay, and that will, in order for us to not lose money on them, what price will we be offering those at?
$10 or free to speakers.
Right, okay. And the tote bags, the price?
$20 each.
Oh, okay. I think that's a little lower than it was before, isn't it? Mm-mm. 25. Nope.
Well, that's what we sell them for. That's not what they cost us to make, but.
Okay, let me ask you, how much do it cost us to make?
They're about $35 each.
Okay. The preface on my comment about how much are we selling them for was, how much do we sell them for without losing money? So,
we're going to pay tax on anything that is marked as merchandise. The museum is going to automatically deduct that from our account. So, I won't even see that. That's something I have to work out with the accountant, but it will get taxed by the museum.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but that's not the question we're working on.
Well, I mean, if you're worrying about how much we're making, that would matter.
No, I'm worried about how much we're losing.
Well, we're not here to make money, and we've always sold them at a loss. They're
true. Is this a bigger loss or a less loss?
This would be about the same loss. I think they were about the same price before.
Okay. Okay, well, so what is the people's consensus on these levels? Are they suitable?
Which object are we talking about?
We're talking about the both items, the coffee cups and the expenditures for her buying the tote bags also. So it's our approval of the merch manager to restock her supply, and it's going to cost us around $1,500. So I'll vote yes. Go ahead and do it.
Okay.
All right. I'll vote yes.
Okay.
Okay. Hank, do you want to vote?
I think I'd vote no. Sorry.
Okay, well, there were more yeses than noes. So the motion passes. Okay, you're approved to go ahead with the purchase as you presented.
Thank you.
How many cups are you getting, Pat?
72. That seems to be the...
That's like the size they like, the bulk, the quantum.
Okay.
Are they same cups or different size at all? Or?
No, they're the same.
Same ones.
They're just more newer ones. The more of the same.
Right.
Okay, it looks like Ron gave up again.
Yeah.
So.
Hi, guys.
Hey, Tim.
Hey, Tim.
Hi.
Feeling better?
Hank. I haven't seen Hank in a long time.
Hey, Tim. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Hey, everybody else.
I am definitely feeling better. As a matter of fact, I just got in from outside, but you guys are hardy if you go out tonight. You are hardy souls.
Okay. So I think our program of meeting in the live meetings in Farrand Hall for the monthly meeting, I think that's working out okay. Mm-hmm. And I think that there's no reason, because we said we'd try it for limited time. And I think that it's only been a short time, but I think it's working out. We should continue it.
Yeah. Okay. So and we'll levels are dropping.
Tom?
Chrissy, I need to get that copy of the show.
So our speaker actually, as soon as he saw I hit the record button, approached me and said, I don't want this to be recorded. Please don't record it. So okay. There is no recording of this meeting. I obviously deferred to him.
Okay.
So that may be in the future something we may want to ask speakers ahead of time. Are you okay with us recording the meeting?
Yeah.
Because who's
we
not?
Can send it out to the members too, letting them know that it won't be recorded if they're counting on viewing it later.
Yeah, I would. Who's been watching the monthly meetings on Zoom and can tell me what their experience is? Because I think most of us have been watching in person. So I'm not super prepared to like say it's going great if the Zoom experience is not great. Tim, how has the Zoom experience been?
The first one was I was very reluctant to stay because the microphone situation didn't work.
Yeah.
So after that, you figured that microphone situation, the speaker can be heard. Still, the people that are asking questions or comments in the audience can't be heard yet.
Yeah, that's not a thing we're going to be able to fix.
Okay, because otherwise what can probably be recommended then is that the person at the podium
maybe restates the question. Yeah.
That's our fix to it.
That's the fix. It's a perfect fix. But otherwise, it's just great.
Okay.
I would agree. I saw the last meeting by Zoom, and I didn't have a problem with it.
Okay, let's let Tom speak. He's got his hand up very patiently.
Well, I just wanted to ask Chrissy, do we have a portable mic there that could be hooked into the sound system? That, you know, it'll be, you know, a mic that you grab onto that would tie in.
No, we don't have a wireless mic in there. We could, I guess, get a second microphone on a really long cable or get a wireless microphone. But most people don't want to wait to have someone bring them the microphone to say it. I think people in the audience just want to say their thing. But we can try it. I mean, it has a very, like, you know, tent revival feel to it.
So will the museum provide that microphone?
The museum would not provide that.
So then we would have to get that microphone.
Correct.
Okay.
Sounds like better to have the speaker just repeat the question.
Tim, what do you want to say?
I absolutely think that the speaker just needs to repeat the question. And if it's a really, really long comment, you can just summarize.
Okay.
It's because in context, I've been able to ascertain what was actually asked just by the responses.
Okay.
And it will save a ton of time from passing a microphone around. That ain't gonna fly.
So does anyone have a dissenting opinion from that? Wants to speak? Okay, we'll go with that.
We just need to, I wish Ron could be on this. We need to tell Ron what we just talked about. So that way Ron he can relay it to the speaker.
Ron can see recording, then comment later.
You think he's going to know how to play YouTube? I guess so.
Well, yeah, if I put it up on YouTube, yeah, he'll be able to see it. Yeah.
Well, I notice on YouTube, we have now have over 100 subscribers to our Monday show.
Congratulations.
To everything there. Yeah. Well, yeah. Most of them are from Russia.
I understand that Chinese are sending balloons over to improve their pickup for our show.
And objects.
Yeah. Pat?
I do have a question or a comment. Ron had said offhand to the speaker after he was done speaking, oh, you should be an honorary member. Yes. And I'm wondering, that's something that the board had said that we would do as a board decision. Now I'm wondering, should we make the decision before we hear the speaker and just say, you're an honorary member for a year, or do we do it in the moment? I'm not clear.
Those are good questions. We had a discussion a short while ago about changing the categories of speakers' remunerations. We had and membership levels and the dues available, but I don't recall if we retained honorary membership. I know we have lifetime honorary memberships that we have awarded in the past, and I assume we're not going to wipe those out.
No.
So it seems to me that then we can continue to do that on a rare occasion.
But not life memberships, unless it's a really good occasion.
Okay.
Yeah.
What's the difference between an honorary membership and a membership?
The honorary one is temporary, like for a year.
Oh, okay. Well, we could put that in our charter.
Okay.
Tom?
Well, I like the idea of any outside speakers that are, you know, not local, that they have a lifetime membership that we could send things. It doesn't cost us anything to keep on a list, and that makes a connection to perhaps other speakers that might want to consider us as a club. So it makes our community a little bit bigger. It doesn't really cost us anything, and
it's a little bit of a pain to deal with.
It's just a name and an email address. That's all. I have friends of SBAU and send out emails to.
Yeah.
Otherwise, we could charge people to show up that show up to our meetings and get money from them. That'd be a real membership. But I mean, it's just sending a notice out. It's of what we have going on. I mean, it really is. I think it's just a great extension.
I don't see any reason to do it permanently, though.
Well, they can unsubscribe.
Okay. Well, how do we know that?
The emails won't go through to them. I guess it won't hear from them. How
well,
do we know?
That's not how we send emails from secretary. So that's a whole new mechanism we'll have to come up with.
Hmm. Yeah. It would have to be for something special, right?
Hank wants to speak. Let him go ahead.
It would have to be for something special, right? I mean, pretty soon with one speaker a month, you'd have like more honorary members than members. And I don't think that's proper, in my opinion.
I don't think it would hurt anything.
Oh,
well, as it is, we were at what, 130, 170 members or something, and
173
renewal notices, and we're down to like 70.
70 what?
Members.
That have responded to their renewal notice?
Yeah.
No, I kind of agree with Hank. It could really clog up our membership roles.
Yeah.
So. Something's going on. Pat, you want to say something?
Oh, I had meant put together a member status as of today. Current members, there's 173 with 5 comps, and that's Mount Wilson, Orange County astronomers, and 3 others. And there's 2 lifers. So there's 7 who aren't paying. So that means 166 should be paying, but members with dues to pay as of March 1st, 2023 are 102.
Yeah.
And so we're sending out a second and last renewal notice this Wednesday.
Okay.
So the paying members right now who are current on their dues are 64.
Okay.
So
we've suffered from 2 years or 2.5 years of COVID then.
Yeah.
And just a lot of extra emails and names being put on the list.
Okay. Okay. Hank, you had your hand up?
Yeah. I mean, I haven't paid yet, but just to avoid the hassle of writing a check and sending it in the mail, I would rather go to a meeting and pay the $20 there. It's just, if it could be made easier, that would help, I think.
Or send an email saying you're planning to do that and we'll have notice of it.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
The meetings are open to the public, whether they pay or not.
Yeah.
And whether you're a member or not.
Yeah. So, but I read in an email somewhere that you could just bring the money and then you're good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Can do that. Yeah. Tom?
Just to let you know, I'm MailChimp, sending out to 200 and some people. On the first Friday meeting for February 3rd, 55% of those, or 115 of those emails are open. So that's more than half the 200 that people actually clicked on the emails that MailChimp reports back. And like tonight's Zoom meeting, 100 emails were opened for the Zoom planning meeting that I sent out to all 200 some people.
Okay.
208. I have a list of 211 contacts, 208 are subscribers, supposedly. It's just because I've used past membership lists from Colin back a couple of years ago, at least.
Yeah.
And so just to let you know, so we've got over 100 opens of the 200, 115 again for the first Friday meeting.
So I don't think we should continue sending notices to non-paying members. So as it comes up for renewal, you give them, as I think Pat was suggesting, a final one, and then a month later or something, then they're no longer receiving our mailings. Does anyone think that's a good or a bad idea?
Good idea for me.
Yeah.
Okay.
So what we were deciding was we would send one 2 months before, and then 15 days before they were due, we would send a second and final. It does get a little tricky for the ones who are give or who receive outreach credit, because everybody who received outreach credit is due March 1st. So if we send them notices in January, then later on in January, we find out if they have outreach credit. So anyway, but in the general year, we're going to do it 2 months before and then 15 days before. So, okay, Hank, you have just a few more days.
Okay, yeah.
We're draconian.
Well, is it cloudy tonight? Because otherwise I'll go over tonight. I think it's cloudy.
It's pretty cloudy.
Yeah.
Tim, go ahead.
My only comment on the not mailing out the 200 is that, you know how in advertising people, they constantly remind you by sending you a message or an email, don't forget us. And is it too big of a hassle to every now and then send out some kind of reminder? If you want to get a newsletter, remember you can join the club for this.
Yeah, I don't have good thoughts about the companies that keep sending me notices.
Yeah.
I don't either, but it does work.
But not with me, it does.
Yeah. Okay. Point well taken.
Okay, Tom?
What about notifying like the profs over at UCSB or Las Cumbres Observatory notifications? Sandy Seal sends us stuff from Las Cumbres. She may or may not be a member. The Museum of Natural History folks.
No, I wouldn't bother them either. I wouldn't. I'd let them decide they want to join and then look us up.
And I think Sandy Seal is a member. So,
well, she hasn't paid.
Yeah, she hasn't paid, but.
Well, she probably will.
Okay, hopefully.
Well, yeah, I don't know. It just seems like we're limiting ourselves somehow. But
I don't know. We're not an advertising money-making thing. We're here to do public outreach and to the general population and not be an irritant, in my view.
And Sandy does kind of keep track of us because she sends emails from all the LCO stuff to us.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. I think as long as we're advertising out to the public, that's at least a connection that someone should be able to see. So I guess that would be the main thing.
Wait, we're not advertising to the public. We're not hounding them to be members.
Yeah,
that's where I'm at.
I didn't say that.
I get notices.
You put words in my mouth on that, Jerry. I think you put words in my mouth on saying that hounding someone. I didn't say that. I just said about, you know, as long as we're advertising, that, you know, we're at least people know that we exist. I just didn't want to lose that.
Yeah, I get VCAS notifications of speakers, and I think sending out that we have a speaker that's publicly available each month, I think that's, you can send that out to Congress if you want. I don't care. I mean, I think that's fine. Matter of fact, that might be a good idea. My balloon, yeah.
I don't think we want Taylor Greene yelling and pointing in our meeting.
Jerry, what is VCAST? What is that?
Ventura County Astronomical Association.
VCAST, Ventura County Astronomical Society. They send us emails.
Yeah. Yeah. It's the one that, what's his name? Mike Chibnick. President of.
Yeah. Used to be. Yeah.
Yeah. Now he's president of the Rio Vista Astronomical Society. It's got a different name, but he's up there. Ah. Colin, go ahead.
I'd suggest that you might want to put a link to their website, if they have one, on our website. Because, yeah, I get their stuff, too. It's good to stay in touch with them, I think. But we should have a link on the website, I would think.
We do have links on the website to a number of other organizations in the area that are of interest to amateur astronomers. Don't we, Tom?
I'm pretty sure we do. I haven't noticed that.
Yeah, I think VCAS is on there if I had to.
Yeah, we've got Ventura, Vandenberg, Central Coast, and Griffith Observatory. Local astronomy clubs listed here.
And
yeah.
Vandenberg is no longer a club called Vandenberg. Now they're the Lompoc Astronomical Society, LAS.
Interesting. Yeah.
So we should put LCO on there if it wasn't on there.
Yeah, LCO's on there.
Okay.
Yeah, Vandenberg link doesn't work.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, they're not. Any other topics?
I think this is the right time to start thinking of. Just a minute, Tom. It's right time to start thinking about field trips. Maybe buying an all night at Mount Wilson or a day trip to Griffith Observatory. I went on one about 5 years ago and it was great.
Brandy's voting for a trip to Griffith.
Where do you see something?
Oh, Brandy's here with me at the observatory.
Oh, I see. She's okay. Okay. Yeah, I forgot about that. Tom had his hand up first.
Okay.
I've forgotten.
Okay. the power of short-term memory. Okay. Pat, go ahead.
Okay. I do. I remember that we were talking about Mount Wilson last year.
Yes.
And they hadn't updated their website about 2023 yet. So okay. I have a note to myself in March to take a look at their website. They have to deal with weather up there. So, and fires. So it might be that even in March, they might not have the dates, but at least I'll look and let everybody know. As far as Griffith goes, whoever wants to take it on, it's more than wonderful.
Griffith will be a lot easier than Mount Wilson.
Yes. Yeah. Hank?
Yeah, that's a little further down the road, but there's the Kaibab Lodge Star Party coming up. That's by the Grand Canyon or the Grand Canyon Star Party.
Oh, so that's the North Rim.
Yeah, the North Rim. Ever since the RTMC got closed, I was looking for an alternative. And I've gone there twice, and it's actually very nice over there.
Okay.
The North Rim is much quieter than the South Rim. It's a lush area. There are bison roaming around, and, you know, it's okay, so...
Yeah, I've been there a number of times. It's beautiful. It's like
yeah, so there is a small star party going on there, and it's organized by some people from the Tucson, I believe. So they have every day they have a presentation in the Kaibab Lodge itself. They have a room for that, and it's kind of cool. Something to keep in mind. It's a long distance, of course, so it would help to carpool if anybody's interested. But once you're there, it's kind of nice to roam around in the daytime.
Yeah. And, it's a good suggestion.
And the skies, by the way, the skies can be fantastic. I have to say, last year the monsoon happened, and we only had half a night of clear sky. But if the sky is clear, it's incredibly clear.
Okay, Chuck?
That's something I would say, Hank. Write a little article about it, you know, as the time gets closer. Submit it to the newsletter, and we'll mention it at meetings, and then we can ask people to sign. You know, people can get in contact with each other as far as getting together and going.
Yes. And time to sign up soon, actually, because the Kaibab Lodge it's going to be limited how much space there is. They have very nice cabins. Right. They're not cheap, but it's worthwhile having one. And they have different kinds. You can take like one quarter of a cabin, or you can take a whole cabin. But there's also right next door is the is a campground. So you can sign up there as well. And further up the road is Jacob Lake, where you can usually, if there's no other place, you can go there as well. Anyway, just something. It's just a nice place to be for a week and have nothing to think about, just looking at the bisons in the meadows and around a little bit.
Don't get too close to them. No, those are all the topics that I have. If you, I guess we need to assign anyone who's interested to look into the Griffith trip. Tom, are you volunteering or do you want to ask a question?
No, I just want to add to the topic here just want to mention our donations that we've recently received. The Celestron CPC 1100 from Eric Klein, who just didn't seem the need to keep it anymore. And so that's a new scope for the club. And then Charles Schuler has donated his 14-inch Dobsonian to the club. It's in the shed at this moment. The 1100 is in my garage at the moment, which we used up at the Dunn's School, right?
Dunn's School.
It was very, very nice, even though I forgot how to use the battery properly. The battery was working. I just didn't have make the right connection there. I could have used that instead of tying into Chuck's power. But two amazing scopes. And I think Art had no problem with this, talked to him recently. He's got some kind of kidney issue coming up that he's got to work on. That the 12-inch Dob, large Dob that we have called the Star Splitter, is one that we can pass on to someone else, sell that off, and make a little bit more room that way. The 14-inch Dob takes up less room.
Okay.
So you sold the 8-inch too.
The 8-inch, I had five people in this last week wanting to buy that thing.
Nice.
It's like, I got it to the first guy, and I could have sold it for 500 instead of 400 probably. but we got $400 in our hands here. I need to get some stuff over to Colin. But
Colin is looking forward to that.
Yeah, I got to get over there. Let's see what else. And there's an empty tripod in the shed that. I believe it belonged to a big mead that Art has at his house, but he's working on one, looking for a panel continuously, trying to last few years, and it's been kind of just put on the wayside. And so he said I could fold up that tripod and rolling cart and make a little bit more room in the shed that way.
Maybe use the rolling cart for the CPC.
Yeah.
That's a possibility, I guess. Yeah, that's true. I kind of like the cart the CPC's in that has a cart that came with it, although it doesn't fit in my truck very well. But I'd have to roll up the – I have a cover over the pickup bed that I have that it sticks up too high one way or another, no matter which way you put it. But anyway, yeah, it comes with its own cart, that CPC 11. It's 62 pounds to lift up and down on a tripod. I can handle it, but it's, and as long as you don't put the tripod up any higher than its minimum, which they say is a good way to go anyway. So those are great donations we have there that I gave both of them a letter. And then you guys said about don't put valuations in the letter. I'd mentioned on the one letter, but I guess you must have seen that. I must have passed it on that. I'd say, it's used condition. It's probably worth $5,000. That's all I said on the letter. I didn't say it was, but I did say check with the tax person. And for Charles, I didn't leave any price on that, so he can do what he wants with that.
Good.
So, yeah, so it's just amazing scopes that we have.
I hear you got an amazing scope case also donated.
Oh,
well, yes, that's right. Jerry donated a padded case to. Or I don't know what big size that thing is. It's pretty big. I think, you know, the one I just sold today had came with the case that fit the 8-inch dob perfectly, the nice padded case. Nice. And he did well. It had a rolling base that came with it and eyepieces. And so he was real set today with his purchase. A young guy, pregnant wife, young kids, and came down from Soledad to purchase it.
Wow.
So yeah, he beat the crowd that wanted that thing. Another guy from Ojai wanted it. So it's just, yeah, it was getting very popular this week for some reason. Anyway, so that's, so yeah, so I think I mentioned all I need to there. And let's see. Oh, so the planetarium, we're waiting on our financing to make that official, the planetarium hardware donation, huh?
I have
we just need to purchase our own Colin. We're go for that.
I'm sorry, I was talking. I didn't hear you, Chuck.
Well, we've got the, all we need is for Colin to do the purchase order, and we're go for that.
Yeah. Okay. Colin?
In fact, that's if you tell me how much and how to make it out, I will do that. I also have a purchase order for Tom. I think I got the email, so I'll get that done. And then I'm going to need a purchase order from Pat on the merchandise thing. Eventually. So as far as I know, those are the three purchase orders, and I'm not sure what was the museum. So is it 8,000 you want made out?
Yes.
Okay. And I can talk to the accountant and see how they want it worded or how they want it made out and do that.
Wonderful.
There'll be a specific like code they want to use. So just check in with Emil. She'll know what to do with that. Emil,
yeah. I'll work with her and see how she wants it set up and do the purchase order.
Okay. Pat?
I'm just curious, Chrissy, do you have anything to tell the club?
No, I can't think of anything. I mean, we have astronomy day coming up. I think we should start talking about it by the next meeting.
April 29th, we're all set with the big box.
Okay, great. And also another thing to be thinking about, the museum would love to support programming for the next two eclipses. They don't want to host them here on site because of what happened last time with, you know, like 1,000 people. We cannot accommodate that. It doesn't work with our CUP with the city. We could get in like really big trouble. So if we can think of an alternate site or sites to be at for those eclipses, that would be fantastic.
The big box is usually pretty good about that. They like us, so I can ask them.
Great.
You
fantastic.
Have too many trees at the museum for an eclipse anyway.
Yeah, it's not optimal for viewing it in any case. We don't have the parking. We don't have the viewing. Yeah. We cannot accommodate thousands of people very easily.
Okay.
We sure tried Mr. last Sunday.
Yeah.
So, it was interesting.
Okay, does anyone else have any other topics they want to talk about, Tom?
I have a topic and I can't remember what it is.
You need a secretary.
Oh, yeah, here it is. Okay, it's the secretaries. You know, I'm recording the meeting. You guys want to make the summary of the meeting as to, is there a minutes that you want to create? From that, there's an audio file from the recording that I can send to you. And also, I'm actually trying to record using this Otter device that actually prints out the conversations that we're having here. Although it's, since I don't pay for it, I have to do it, cut it up in 2 half-hour sections. But would you guys want to make minutes and I should send this to you? And for, you know, I sent out this email today. That's another question is, I sent out the MailChimp. Do you want to take that over in any way, and we could compare the MailChimp list of people with what you have for members that should be notified, and you could do MailChimp for sending out notifications, which is a nice way to go because people can unsubscribe or whatever, which is kind of required for emails, in a sense, for organizations. So are you guys interested in either of those things, for making the minutes for the meeting and or doing MailChimp, or want to do, I mean, I made the notification. No one asked me to. I just did it because, it seems like that would be the secretary's to be able to do that.
Yeah, we'll be glad to do that. We'll just need to get the link from you, you know, if it changes.
I think I sent you the information on MailChimp. Four, didn't I?
Yeah, you did. But we would need to get the if the Zoom parameters change at all,
right?
You know, each month before we send it out.
Yeah, but generally it's the same right now.
Okay. Yeah, we can do that. And I guess it'd be great to get a transcript if you have an easy way of producing that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful.
Okay.
Good. All Chuck's right. Work is cut out for him. How does the sky look, Chuck?
Okay. It's clear overhead.
Okay.
Hold on for a second. Let's take a look at the weather real quick and see what shows.
It's only a 40% chance of rain.
That means a 60% chance of no rain.
Let's see. Where are we at here? If I find the weather, where's our weather?
Mars is overhead.
Yeah. And here we do this. And do the click on, like I click on the layers and then I'll click it again. So that's updated view. And if we go back an hour, it was that. So it's kind of circling around, trying to come through.
Pivoting around Gaviota.
Yeah. And then if we do the layer of satellite, what's that look like? So the clouds are coming as well with it.
Yeah, it looks like coming from the south.
So is it a bunch of sucker holes going on, Chuck? Or
there's
what?
A huge sucker hole overhead right now.
Yeah, it's been looking pretty good today. So surprisingly, just windy.
That's the sucker hole we want, Chuck. Keep it open.
Yeah, yeah, because that's where Mars is and the comet's next to it. Although the comet might be hard, but
and the Pleiades, like there's some Grab Nebula. Yeah. As long as we keep that tiny patch of the sky is like all we really need. We could do it. We work with a lot with that much of the sky.
Yeah, and we've got Brandy here with a scope, and I've got a scope, so.
And Raphael's coming in. He'll have the big scope running.
Okay.
That's kind of scary, Chrissy, opening up the planetarium and having a storm come by and dumping on you. That's
We'll keep an eye on it. We can close the dome pretty quick.
Yeah, close that.
A couple minutes.
Oh, Brandy has something to say.
Hi, you guys. I have Brandy. My camera. You see that?
No, up higher, higher. Mm-hmm. Gotta go higher, higher, higher.
Higher.
Oh, yeah.
Very important now. Very important.
James Webb Penn. Very good.
Okay.
All right.
Well, I think that's all, unless someone has some other hot topic. That was all we need. Okay. Have fun tonight, and thank you, everybody, for participating.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you. I think Tom Totten is the host, so I'll let him close out the meeting.
Okay. Yeah. Well, just leave as you want there.
Okay.
And I'll end it right now. See you guys.
Okay. Bye.
Bye.
In meeting.